हेलो गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। आई एम डॉक्टर हिमांशु गुप्ता एंड आई हैड सिक्योर्ड अ रैंक ऑफ 62 इन नीट पीजी 2018। आई हैव बीन गाइडिंग स्टूडेंट्स फॉर द पास्ट 2 ईयर्स टू हेल्प देम गेट अ गुड रैंक इन एम्स पीजीआई एंड नीट पीजी। सो टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर वन स्टडी व्लॉग विद यू विच आई हैव बीन वॉन्टिंग टू डू फॉर द पास्ट 2 to 3 months। सो फाइनली टुडे आई एम डूइंग दिस व्लॉग एंड इफ यू लाइक इट do let me know in the comment section below so that I can come up with many such study vlogs with you. So within the vlog I have shared few tricks of studying, also few tricks related to MCQs also, and hope these tricks will be beneficial to you guys. So abhi mere room ki bahut buri halat ho rakhi hai, okay, so अगर प्रोडक्टिव होना है पूरे दिन में तो सबसे पहले अपने रूम को ऑर्गेनाइज करना पड़ेगा।
सो गाइस, व्हाट आई हैव सीन विद स्टूडेंट्स इज दैट देयर डेस्क आर सो क्लटर्ड, इट इज फिल्ड विद बुक्स, इट इज फिल्ड विद क्लोथ्स, यू नो देयर इज नो स्पेस ऑन द टेबल टू रीड। ओके, सो व्हेन आवर डेस्क आर सो क्लटर्ड, यू नो वी विल नॉट इवन फील लाइक स्टडी, वी विल कीप ऑन प्रोक्रेस्टिनेटिंग दिस टास्क ऑफ स्टडी। So what I will want from you guys is that you devote at least 5 minutes to cleaning your table, to cleaning your room, okay? That will give you a positive feeling in the morning itself.
So guys, now you can see my room looks much better now, okay? Now I'm very organized and we can now study.
In the morning guys, I also like to do workout for 20 minutes, okay?
Guys, my room is now all organized and now I will begin preparing for my next class, and I will explain you how you have to study properly, how you have to do your notes effectively, and let us begin guys. So guys, before studying I set a timer of 30 minutes and I promised myself that for 30 minutes I will try to stay focused. It is difficult to stay focused for more than 30 minutes and I follow this Pomodoro technique. And I also take an overview of my chapter Antimicrobial Introduction, and I get to know that I have to read about antimicrobial drugs effect, the time dependent killing effect, the concentration dependent killing effect, the various drug resistances, the intrinsic and the acquired resistance, then the biofilm formation in bacteria, then mechanism of cell wall synthesis in bacteria, and the various drugs that inhibit this cell wall synthesis. So after taking an overview, I try to read these topics in detail. You know, an interesting thing that I found was that there is intrinsic resistance also, and this intrinsic resistance is shown by anaerobes which are not acted upon by aminoglycosides. The vancomycin is not active against gram-negative bacteria. The acquired resistance, the best example was the bacteria activate efflux pumps which are active against beta-lactams, tetracyclines and fluoroquinolones. And the important point in cell wall synthesis was that these beta-lactams that we study in detail, they inhibit the enzyme transpeptidase. The cycloserine, which is the second line drug for tuberculosis, it inhibits alanine ligase, and this phosphomycin inhibits enol pyruvate transferase. The drug causing Redman syndrome, it inhibits the cross-linking of D-alanine. And then I try to read about all these drugs in detail and I get to know that this cycloserine drug has neuropsychiatric side effects. The bacitracin has nephrotoxic effects, and this vancomycin causes Redman syndrome due to the increased release of histamine.
So now guys, I begin my second round of Pomodoro. And I have just taken a very short break of 10 minutes. And what mistake that students do is that they take very long breaks. You know, they hang out with their friends. They even like waste 2 hours in between their 2 study periods. So don't do this mistake. So I read about beta-lactams in detail now, and I found that these penicillins are very short acting because they are easily excreted in the urine. The broad spectrum penicillins, they are also classified based on their functional group. Penicillin G has a very poor oral absorption, and to counter this we have an acid stable penicillin, that is penicillin V. And you know, these penicillins can be made longer acting by inhibiting their excretion in the urine. And you will tell me which is the drug that inhibits its secretion. Then they can also be made longer acting by increasing their water solubility. Before moving further, I also want to give credits to these amazing notes by Dr. Ranjan Patel sir, who is a faculty at Marrow. Then penicillin can be used in syphilis, and they can also give Jarisch-Hemer reaction in secondary syphilis. Then the mechanism of resistance to penicillin is by decreased purine production, drug efflux, and the resistance to penicillin can also be due to altered transpeptidase and beta-lactamase production. Remember, the drug of choice in organisms producing extended spectrum beta-lactamases is carbapenems. So it is a very important question that I feel like I have to remember very well. Now coming to penicillinase resistant penicillin. Okay, so it is remembered with a very famous mnemonic, that is condom drugs. And you can read about all the drugs in detail. Then we have in MRSA, it is very simple, the drug of choice is vancomycin. Now I come to guys, cephalosporins, they have been very confusing to me all throughout my MBBS. And when I'm teaching this topic to the students, I feel very confused now also. So what I make a simple mnemonic for third generation. I make a mnemonic that all of them have TR in their names. The fifth generation have RO in their names. And fourth generation have P in their names, whereas the first generation have FA in their names. The only exception to this was cefaclor and cefamendol, which were second generation cephalosporins. And I also found that these ceftaroline and ceftobirol are given in MRSA infection. And another important drug that is in carbapenems, it is imipenem, and it is metabolized by renal dihydropeptidase. So it is combined with cilastin, which is a renal dihydropeptidase inhibitor, which makes it a longer acting drug. So now guys, I was tired of reading the theory for an hour, and I tried doing some MCQs from the online question bank. So it is always a good idea, if you are getting bored with doing your theory, you can always have a look at the online question bank. And there is one more way with which you can utilize this online question bank. Before starting to read any chapter or any theory from the notes, just try to have a look at all the questions. This will give you an idea on what all topics you need to focus on. Even after reading my notes, I got so many questions wrong. That is the benefit. That is the benefit of doing the questions. Like the first question that I solved was the organism most sensitive to penicillin. I did not focus this point while reading my notes, but only after doing the questions, I realized that Treponema pallidum was the organism most sensitive to penicillin. You don't have to always be discouraged by doing the MCQs, by getting so many questions wrong. You know, even if you are getting few questions correct, you have to feel good about yourself. I got encouraged that even after reading pharma after 3 years, I was able to answer few questions correctly. And guys, that is the magic of reading. In the explanation, I found that tetracyclines are the drug of choice for rickettsial infection. So guys, many of you keep on asking that, sir, what should we add in the notes from the explanation. So here I found that this was just two words that I had to write in my notes, and they would answer my one MCQ. And this is what I did. And if you cannot add the whole question, there is one
new feature that is given in this application, that is the MCQ ID. You can always utilize this MCQ ID and you can write it in front of the notes so that you can have a look at that MCQ again when you are reading that topic. I only knew about carbapenems being effective against ESBL, but after doing the questions, I realized that piperacillin and tazobactam are also effective against ESBL producing organisms. Nafacillin causes neutropenia. This was another extra point that I added to my notes. So guys, this was all for today, and after this I just had dinner with my friends, and hopefully my lecture was prepared and I'll be able to take a very good lecture on this topic.